Hi, and welcome to a third section of electrolysis. Please go back and look at the other ones because that's where the detail is. This is just an overview of the uses of electrolysis. Here we've got the three different types of electrolysis that you need to learn about. This one, electrolysis of brine, and what useful products it makes. This one is the purification of copper, and this one is when you do electroplating, which is plating, gold plating, silver plating, things like that. So this is the first one, electrolysis of brine. Again, that's in detail on the electrolysis solution YouTube clip. You've got your sodium chloride solution known as brine, because brine is salt water, like seawater here. So NaCl in water, in solution. In it goes here into this system. And remember, it's that fight of which one gets to go out on each electrode. Chlorine on this one, hydrogen on this one, and then we're left with sodium hydroxide. They're all separated with this membrane here. Now, you've got to know a few of the uses for each of those. I suggest learning about two for each. So chlorine, quite a straightforward one, goes here about swimming pools because it's a disinfectant, and it also is used in bleach. Okay, there are other things. It's used to make hydrochloric acid as well. Hydrogen is used for margarines. Remember, it's used, this is in your core subject, it's used by hydrogenation when you add hydrogen to harden up like olive oils and things like that. So it's used for margarine. It's used as a fuel. One of the new fuel types of in the cars is a hydrogen fuel. And another one, making ammonia. We need hydrogen to make ammonia, which is in the Haber process, which is later on. The sodium hydroxide is used for soap. It's also used for bleach too. So it's also used for paper, you could remember. But a couple of those, I'd make a card on a couple of those. Moving on to this one, just a bit more detail. This is purification of copper. On here we've got the impure copper on this electrode. And on the negative one is some pure copper on the negative one. And what happens is the copper atoms here on this side here, they lose electrons. So that's oxidized, remember, because oxidation is loss of electrons. They lose electrons and become ions. And once they've become ions, they move across because they're attracted to the negative electrode. And as they come to the negative electrode, they turn back into copper atoms. And there's half equations for that you could use. So here at the pure end here, we've got our Cu2 plus. Add the two electrons back to make it, a copper atom. Okay, again, that is on the half equations YouTube clip. So that's what happens here. You get left with some impurities, all the bits that you don't want left down the bottom of that copper electrode. So the difference here is the electrodes are made out of impure copper and pure copper rather than carbon. The last one here is electroplating. The thing that you want to be covered, you put at the negative because you want it to attract metal ions. So in this case, we've got silver. And if you want to plate that spoon with silver, you put the silver here on the positive electrode, and those silver atoms become ions, which then become atoms again as they cover the spoon. And the spoon is then covered in this silver plate. Gold-plated necklace, you just exchange this for gold, and you put whatever you want here to be gold-plated. It's always negative on this side so that they attract the metal ions, which are positive. In solution around it, you need to have the same ions, the same positive ions, because no good having different ones in there, otherwise your spoon will get covered in something else. So here in this one, we've got silver ions, you see, in that silver nitrate solution there. So we've got silver ions wobbling around the place. If it was gold, you'd have to have gold nitrate or something like that in solution so that the spoon would only get covered in silver or gold or whatever you're plating it in. And that's that. Ta-ra.